It's like the Super Bowl on steroids. Remember the closures in downtown Phoenix for the big game? Now imagine if that closure went on for more than a mile.
As Cronkite News reporter Megan Finnerty tells us, while the streets of Cleveland are well organized, it's still not business as usual.
Tens of thousands came into Cleveland for the Republican National Convention, and with them, road closures, parking bans, and security zones that have disrupted daily life here.
I usually bike around a lot. I've had to take the bus though because of all the blockades and all the craziness around here and traffic. Kind of have to take the bus. It's a bit more of a safer route to go.
Safety is the main reason for the closures. That has reassured Arizona delegate Debbie Lesko.
Well, before I came, I was a little nervous with all the different demonstrations going on throughout the country and in Phoenix, quite frankly. And I thought, wow, this is quite the terrorist spot and also protester spot. So I was nervous, but quite frankly, I haven't seen a protester yet.
Cleveland has designated secure areas with 8-foot-tall steel grates and streets manned by cops, soldiers, and Secret Service.
I feel safe. I feel like there's no harm. There's so many people down here and so much happening that I just don't feel that anything's gonna happen.
In preparation, public transit has added trolleys and created deals for convention goers.
Normally people do come by car a lot to downtown, and now people are taking more public transportation.
Lyft and Uber also made special arrangements for the RNC. Harold Wagner, an Uber driver, came in town specifically for the convention.
It was supposed to be a very busy weekend, so I came to see if I could make some extra money.
A Lyft official said it grew their amount of drivers and expanded their coverage area. Uber also created a lounge at the corner of 3rd and Frankfort for riders to wait. Lesko praised the city for its security and transportation.
The city of Cleveland has done an excellent job of organizing this.
Getting around downtown Cleveland from the Quicken Loans Arena to the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame is difficult but doable. In Cleveland, Megan Finnerty, Cronkite News.